a good movie, if you, after 10 minutes, still think you are in a movie, it's not a good movie.
Right,
if you
right.
lost yourself and are in the movie, then it's a good movie. Mm. So this is something where the quality of the story, of course, plays a significant role.
I noticed in your title, Professor of Creative Technology. So there's two interesting right. words coming together, technology and creativity.
Yes.
And, you know, whether you're talking about etchings on cave walls or whether you're talking about modern smart technologies, there seems to be some sense in which we're bringing a creativity to the table, but also we're using technology, whether it's as simple as a stick in the sand to, you know, draw a picture, or whether it's very sophisticated immersive systems, we're using that to kind of supplement and augment, as you say, too.
It goes back to storytelling. If creative things are about storytelling, about characters, about emotions, about conveying something in between humans that that tells a story, and that goes back to sitting at the bonfire together and the storyteller telling things from his life, and the whole tribe sitting and listening to painting on the walls, which is a first level maybe of expression, or building first artifacts out of wood or whatever they did back.
Right.
But it is still the same thing of wanting to tell stories, and the elements of that are the same. So it's characters, it is things that happen, and it's tragedy, it's fun. So there's a couple of basic things you can tell, and humans still also do the same things they did a few thousand years ago. But as you say, the technologies change and the opportunities change, and then later we had film, 2D film, where you go into a cinema as an example, right? And you there is a director that selects a couple of visual scenes that he puts together in a way that it would tell a story and convey an emotion. And there is a certain language developed in filmmaking, how to tell, for instance, an over-shoulder shot or things. And also the technology around it, where to place a scenery and how to frame pictures, all of that has been developed with the focus of that medium, which was film. That was also fully immersive if you put yourself into a cinema and let yourself go into the movie. Also reading a book is fully immersive now, although it doesn't have any of the technologies that we today speak about as immersive technologies like we are. So that thinking around such things gave me this well, for me personally, the insight that is not new, that it's a storytelling, and we are evolving new tools, we are creating new technologies that put the creatives into the position to tell their stories and create new aesthetics and all of this around. And this then later evolved when I started again looking very much into virtual reality.
Any kind of life learning or big themes that stand out for you that you think would be helpful to share?
The more enthusiasm I could bring into some of the things I've been doing, the better it got in the end. In work life, there you have different things to do, there are different duties, some you like more, some you like less, but choosing something that you can really engage with and lose yourself in, then it's not work anymore, and then you just go for the enthusiasm and could work day and night just to get the thing done. Also, when the reward is not the thing that you are up for, but the actual doing of it. And that could have been something like making music or playing football or doing some of the research I did. But this total engagement and enthusiasm towards the thing was something that brought me the most in the end. If you follow your intuition with a good background and education, then you're on a good track.